something complicated. It's great.
So no Adidas, only Nike.
So this, Nike is or opposite. So I do Nike fit in my shoulder, but I bring it to my front feet. So I bring Nike fit in to my shoulder, but I bring it to my front feet. My front feet. So I, and most important, you bring it to your shoulders working. Please align your body straight. If I'm not aligned, it doesn't work. I have to be aligned. I have to be aligned to make it work. So, we start from here. Doesn't matter what you do. And watch my finger. My finger is showing the Nike. But very important when you liberate the shoulder, if you feel your leg supporting. Also when I go back, my leg supports my feet. So we are here. I align. Align means straight. And I go. If I make straight wide away, it's very easy. Very easy. Start from here, start with the shoulder, but let it drop to your feet. But be careful, if it drop, don't collapse. Drop it to your feet, and then you will fall. Try. Two shoulders are working, very clear, right? So now, no shoulders are working. Still, we feel something, right? So I align my body. So this should connect to my feet. Now it's not connected. Now it's connected to my back feet, right? So it's connected to my front feet. And I can move it. It has to be connected to my front feet, not to the back feet. Front. So this feet is free. So this is called your stance. A breathe in front. Everything goes down. But if it goes down, it goes up too. It goes up or down. So I need front feet. I lost front feet. And I catch. So I take the front feet and align my body. That's enough to do. If I take the back feet, I kick. So I take the front feet. So we had shoulder movement. The one who brings your arms to your feet. From the feet. This is the back feet. This is the front feet. And Ishawa Sensei will talk about the big toe. The big toe. But now, if I want to move her, go to the front feet and I move. I go to the front feet and now already try. Right. Now my mind outside, right? So my mind is outside. So I bring my mind inside. And then there's nothing. Just void. Yeah. That's called emptiness. There's nothing. In that nothing, you become very light. So there's nothing. That nothing is called the center. There's nothing. Of course, this is called power. But I'm getting older, I have to take a deep stance. Too much work. So I make a drop. Yeah? I make a drop in my mind. Take me the next bit. So now we have the base of the Hibinaki. And again, I need one. Of course, I have two. But I need one. So I train nothing. So I train to make it nothing. But it goes aligned. Of course, it's sharp. And I leave it where it is my sense. Leave it in my sense. But what is this? Nothing. Doesn't matter what leg you take again today, but you have to be aware in which leg you're standing. Normally, your mind goes up. You're fishing at your hands or your partner, but you forgot about your legs. So basic training is to find your legs, your stance. Normally, it should be acquired on the sundown. You have to find your stance. Otherwise, you use your leg. Especially if you are small, female, you have no choice. Because all the people are bigger than you. If you go up, you lose your power. You have to find your stance. And any stance is okay. So, in my case, I've trained my stance a lot. So I know very much my stance. I know. I'm aware when I lose my hand, and which leg I'm standing. Most of you lose it, and then you grip. So if you want to have a strong grip, your partner, if you bend your head, nothing happens. So you need to align yourself, and then you use the grip. So if I'm here, I use the grip, only hands, doesn't function, right? So if I align myself, now I come back to sensei Doren, you have to relax your shoulder. Then the grip works. Yeah. If you drop the shoulder naturally, you should find your belly. The next step is, can you make a line from your belly to one of your feet? Doesn't matter. And then from up, from the feet, back to the hand. So now I show my mind. My mind goes from the shoulder loose, to the belly, to the feet. Then from the feet, I rise from the shoulder, without changing the shoulder, to the grip. Now I have power. Okay. One and two. But if I can drop, of course, if you drop your hand, be careful the shoulder doesn't work. Then only the hand drops. The shoulder stays relaxed. So if we come here, from where I start from, I'm here, right? So, from the leg to the belly to the shoulder, to the hand, back to the shoulder, to the leg. Okay, first. That's the inside move of my head. How I direct my energy inside. Of course, I'm trained, so the whole process goes very fast. If I like to push him from here, right, I need the leg. Doesn't matter which one. But I need, in my case, I prefer this one to align myself, grab the shoulder, and I can move the hand. And that's very important because most in the beginning of Aikido, you use the eyes of the hand. And then this starts to grip. So that's why Sensei Dorin insists on you to relax the shoulder. You have to learn. It takes time because the body is used to take the grip. It takes time. So, now I have promised to do something with Nikyo. I promised something with Nike movement. So, I have to find the Nike movement in my hand. I'm front now, and I can Nike down, right? Nike now, but I go to the Nike leg. Nike goes from here up. Nike. And this complication, right? Called a mistake, right? Called mistake, alright? So I have to find a way. I find a way inside. Not sure. So if you stop. Now, he doesn't say stop. Stops me. That small difference makes Budo Aikido Budo. Yes or no? Yes or no? But there's no violence. I just take a free line towards you. But it's the Nike line. Just do it. Shall I do it? Shall I redo it? Maybe I don't do it today. Too late, you're dead. Right? You do it or you don't do it. I do it. Okay. Or I don't do it. There's no difference in that.
Just do it.
And then you have, like Sensei Dorin said, the do is the Aikido. So Aikido is just do it. Right? But you have to learn that, right? Just do it. So, are you sharp? Are you sharp? Are you dead?
Thank you.
body. It's enough. Try. The more I make it light, the more it's my stance. The more I make it not light, the more I bend my head. That's enough to work. Because if it is light, it's a center point. Make a mistake. He's dead. He's dead. So we have a change, he's still dead. He's still dead. I try to find distance when you lose. This is too short. Of course, we have to intervene now. Right? So I find the right distance. Hard, my body engages a lot, not my arms. Of course, not completely true. When I trained Pisayama, this one, it was going to that one, and it was like a hammer sledge, right? But you don't make friends with that. Alright, if I hear you there, and me going this, not so good idea. So my body. Right. I sense. It's a right point. I keep. I'm right point. Of course, you need the wrong thing. You don't need it. Hold the point without force. Because in reality, only one time. Go to your feet. Not touch your hands. Your feet together. Yes, don't use the hands too much. You use the hands. You need to. Non funziona. So, I'm fast, the hands are going. That's reality. Now for training, don't train all your points. Just fix a point where it's light, and then keep the same point. Move your body. The power can be added to it. Then if needed. The power never ends. Never. In Aikido. So enough, enough. Thank you. Try. Okay. I open the shoulder. So I make the shoulder. If I don't want to use the hand at all, I can lift, put away my leg, or go down with the legs. But I didn't use it yet. The basic is your posture. The basic is the right point. Finish these two holds and two experience to accept it. You will not accept. My belly is searching for her. So my belly is somehow connecting. What I cannot do behind the screen. Belly contact in the screen. Now I can do. And I lift the spirits. Now I can use my leg as free. So I can enter. So before my hands were under, so I go in the same position, and I change, like I'm doing, all starts to be done. Of course, but I'm an Aikido.
So I have a sense, I feel it. I can move.
So the right point has to do with the sense inside the body. For instance, if I'm standing here, I think he feels me now. Right? Now he doesn't feel me. Now he feels, yes, or is it? So I know I'm in the right distance. So if you take two hands, for instance, now I feel I'm not in the right distance, so I create the right distance towards you. Now I am. I can move on. So if I go back to what Doran Sensei was doing, I don't feel I'm on the right distance. Now I am. So right distance means everything is at one point. There's no distortion. This is a distortion. Not anymore. So now I can move if I want. So if I go up now, right, towards him, I'm not yet on the right point. So I make it. Now I am. Because what happens here happens there too. Now I'm not in the right point. So the right point has to do a lot of that you can align yourself straight. Even if you move your leg. So Keizawa sensei put the leg back, but the hips are front. Now they change. Now I lost it, so I'm in front. So if I want to do an exercise to him, right? Now the next important, very important thing, if your hands raise your hand, right, like this, and your legs are shoulder, you have to feel your feet. Otherwise you lose your center. You have to feel your feet. You have always you have to put yourself in the middle. So I don't feel my feet now. Now I feel my feet. So here's one. And that's very important you can maintain. The feeling of the feet. Most of you lose the feeling of the feet. Stay in the feet. So go up. Just an exercise. Don't worry about the martial at the moment. Am I on the right point, yes or no? What do you see? Now?
Yeah, yes.
He feels it too. So we have a common sense in the body, what is the right point. And the whole idea is that you learn that by time to make it in one. But now it helps you. Am I right? Thank you. So it helps me. Now I can liberate. So help each other to find the right point. I help you. Don't push. Right point you need to push. Just one little bit more. Thank you. No. So his difficulty is he's so much busy with me, he cannot feel the feet anymore. Thank you.